Louisville, Kentucky. Today, 10th-ranked Nevada, Las Vegas goes against 4th-ranked Louisville. Welcome, everybody. I'm Jim Nance, along with Billy Packer. Billy, today, two of the hottest teams in the country. UNLV has won 11 games in a row, while the Cardinals have won 12 straight. What about this matchup?
Well, I've mentioned that I think this is Denny's finest team. He has not denied that. Jerry Tarkanian thinks this is one of the best defensive clubs he's ever had, and he's had some of the best in all of college basketball. But I think we have two clubs out here that, in my mind, could be in Seattle in the Final Four. They're that good.
So Final Four flavor here today at Freedom Hall. Jerry Tarkanian running Rebels at 13-2 on the season. Jerry Tarkanian won over 500 games in his outstanding career. He'll start Stacy Augmon, the Olympian, in his front court, along with George Ackles. And David Butler is the center for the Runnin Rebels. In the backcourt, it's Greg Anthony, the sophomore, and Clint Rossum. Denny Crum of the Cardinals. He's taken Louisville six times to the Final Four. He's won two national championships. And he starts today in the front court. Denny Payne, along with Tony Kimbrough, and Pervis Ellison at center. In the backcourt, it's LeBradford Smith and Keith Williams. We're set now for action from Freedom Hall. Louisville control. Smith on the drive. Hit by Payne. And controlled by Austin. UNLV setting up now. Greg Anthony, the point guard, runs the attack for the Runnin Rebels.
Payne on him. It's a little bit of a mismatch there. Anthony's got a lot more quickness, and he's wide open.
David Butler, turnaround. David Butler, a junior. He's a junior college player out of San Jacinto in Texas. He was rated the number one junior college prospect coming out this year.
Anthony right up on Williams. Great foot movement on defense. Jerry Tarkanian says he may be as good as shutting anybody off out there that he's ever had.
Bradford Smith against Augmon, driving past Augmon, dishing to Ellison. Ellison loses control, picked up by Smith. 15 on the shot clock. Payne is open. Rebound, Rossum.
Good rebound for a guard to come in and get one of those loose rebounds that sometimes gets picked up for an easy offensive putback. Straight man-to-man.
Butler's shot is blocked. Blocked by Ellison. Picked up by LeBradford Smith.
Perfect. Keeps his streak going. Top shot blocker in the history of the Metro.
Reaching around, committing the foul is George Ackles. He's had a problem this year staying in the game with fouls.
He's going to have a problem not only staying in the game with fouls, he's going to have a problem staying in the game not doing what Jerry wants defensively, because he got caught right behind Pervis Ellison that time. And with all the great pivot moves that Pervis has, you've got to side him or front him a little bit.
Louisville 12-2 on the season. Cardinals lost their first two games. They've won 12 in a row since that time. A foul away from the ball. Billy, what about the fast start for Denny Crum's
team? Well, as you can see right here, in the last 4 years, Denny's club has lost at least 9 games by this time. This year, obviously, they're off to a great start. 12-2, and those two losses were the first two games of the year.
That year they went 11-5 was 86. They won the national championship. Bradford got his block. Blocked by Butler, and it's UNLV basketball.
Jim, one of the things I see in a game between these two clubs, because they're so athletic in the paint, like two great heavyweight fighters, which one is going to get the best of that early?
Greg Anthony overthrows Rossum, and it's a turnover. Crum and the Cardinals have the basketball, looking for their first points of the afternoon.
What's happening right now is UNLV has taken Louisville out of their offensive patterns by denying the entry pass.
Kimbrough misfires. UNLV on the rebound. The Cardinals are now 0 for 5 from the floor to start the game.
Good block.
Butler has it taken away by Kimbrough. Picked up by Augmon, though. And Augmon dishes to Butler. Butler is called for traveling.
And that's what I was talking about. Teams that are so good in the paint as these two are, facing a club that can block their shots, forces a lot of mistakes on the inside. Maybe the first time this year the Vegas has faced somebody that can handle them down in the paint.
Keith Williams to Tony Kimbrough. Again, a whistle away from the ball.
Ackles was trying to handle Pervis Ellison inside. He did a You'll see he does a great job getting in front of him right here. Fights his way around the top right before that. Then he gets caught on the foul because he tried to work his way around again. Pervis Ellison had him on his hip.
Second foul on Ackles, junior college transfer from Garden City. Cardinals get it inside to Kimbrough, stripped loose by Anthony. Anthony working on Payne. He'll pull up. And a rebound by Kimbrough. Back to LeGrand for Smith. Here comes Louisville. He'll take the three. And Ackles has the rebound. 3 minutes into the game, Louisville still has not scored.
Ackles, Butler, and Augmon are really doing a good job stealing off inside on the court.
Augmon trying to work on Smith. He gives to Butler. Off the glass, no good, but it's off Payne's knee.
I don't know if I've ever seen anybody any quicker inside than these two clubs are with this kind of size.
Really an upset in the making. Number two, Illinois loses. Hoffman has his shot blocked away.
As I said, two heavyweight champs right down in the ring, and they're not used to seeing themselves get their shots blocked. Now, this is a pretty good move. He puts up his left-handed shot. Pervis says nothing like that in here, so you've seen blocks on both ends.
Pervis has now knocked away two shots. Here's the shot by Anthony.
Soft touch.
Greg Anthony, a Las Vegas product, transferred actually from Portland, the University of Portland. Sophomore now for the Runnin Rebels.
Great interior defense by Butler that time to shut off Kimbrough. Jim, as we saw the practice yesterday, nobody in my estimation practices as hard on defense as does Vegas.
So Keith Williams finally gets Louisville on the board. Right down comes Augmon. And he lost control. He's called for traveling. Stacy Augmon, member of the U.S. bronze medal Olympic team.
And you notice that Vegas is throwing over the top of the press, not just the half court, but they're trying to go for a home run.
Kenny Payne with the ball to Ellison. Ellison has the ball knocked away. Going to be the third on Ackles. The three on Ackles. It's a 3-point early lead for the Runnin Rebels. In Louisville, fourth ranked Cardinals against the 10th ranked UNLV Runnin Rebels. Early action, Louisville 1-for-7 from the floor. And here come the Cardinals firing right away in a three by Kenny Payne.
Set out of bounds situation, UNLV not ready to defend. They were in the man-to-man and just went on Payne.
Moses Jury has come in to replace Ackles in the UNLV lineup. Ackles out with the three fouls.
Jury trying to put an elbow on Pervis Ellison.
There's Jury, misses the inside shot. And remains UNLV basketball. Jury is also a transfer from San Jacinto. In Texas, a teammate and a roommate, in fact, of David Butler, starting center for the Runnin Rebels. Picked up by Williams. Out ahead to Smith. Williams underneath to Kimbrough.
Oh, what a
block by Augmon.
And a pass coming, and everybody hustling in this game.
Tried to get the bounce pass past Williams.
Stacy might have been better off giving that up a little bit sooner.
Greg Anthony, number 50. Unusual number for a guard, a point guard, nonetheless.
Okay, got a double zero and a 50. 2 weeks in a row with a double zero. We had Shorter last week from Pitt. Great pump fake.
Over to Rossum and a three. Rossum nails it. Now back in front, though, the Runnin Rebels.
For UNLV, that's the 94th three-point shot they've made on the year so far. 30-some more than Louisville, but Louisville doing a good job with the three as well.
Here's another three. Kimbrough, he misses. Jury pulls it down. Part of the story this year for Louisville. Better three-point shooting. Jury misses. Rebound by Anthony. Baseline Anthony again.
Anthony showed a little bit of vertical leap on that play, Jim.
Cardinals have improved, Billy, though, their three-point shooting, and they've had a lift this year from three freshmen.
A great lift from three freshmen who are actually averaging over 16 points a game by the group, but one of them, Everett Sullivan, today is out.
Ellison inside. Three players all over him. Pervis Ellison.
Louisville may have to go to Ellison more now. He's got Scurry on him, and I think Scurry, with his size, could have some trouble defending against Pervis.
Rossum in the lane. Rebound by, well, picked up by Smith. Got a three on two. And a call for Bradford Smith with the charge. Billy, the top 10 is going to look different come Monday.
Well, it certainly will. Of course, Duke was sitting there at number one spot before the year, and Illinois, who's struggling today, Georgetown playing well, Louisville, Oklahoma. Does it really make any difference at this stage of the year with so many good teams? Arizona with a big win over Villanova, and of course, UNLV at 10.
Well, with Duke dropping two games this week, Illinois was trying to go for number one today, but trailing against Georgia Tech. Georgetown third, and then followed by Louisville.
Jim, on that last play, you have a three-on-one fast break. Bradford Smith, who is really doing a good job converting to a point guard, has got to pull up on that play in between the top of the key and the foul line to create some spacing for his passing. That's why he drew the charge on that play.
UNLV has brought in Stacy Sijanovic for Anthony and some new faces in the lineup for Louisville as well. Felton Spencer, the seven-footer. And traveling called on Butler.
And the reason for the travel, he saw Pervis Ellison there, and he knows about his shot blocking. He also have Anderson Hunt in, so Jerry Tartanian feeling he wants to keep his backcourt fresh. He's made two substitutions.
Four turnovers on UNLV. James Brewer, one of the freshmen now, passes to Smith. Smith will take the shot. And almost gets a soft roll, and there's Ellison. Pervis Ellison. Cornelius Holden, another freshman, is in the Cardinal lineup. The two freshmen for Denny Crum. Three-pointer by Anderson Hunt.
That was an NBA three-pointer.
Freshman out of Detroit, Anderson Hunt.
And notice UNLV playing a little zone now. Dropping back inside without their Greg Anthony out there to play that point defensively.
What a pass, Billy, by Pervis Ellison. He snapped it across the court to Brewer. And here's a steal by Louisville. Here comes Brewer.
And Bradford Smith just coming back on the floor.
Ellison. Oh, beautiful. All key by the Bradford Smith going into the third row to get the steal. Pervis Ellison just passed Bill Wagner to move into second place on Louisville's career scoring list.
There's a touch call on Pervis Ellison. There was no threat whatsoever that an entry pass was going to be made. Denny Crum saying there was pushing off inside, but Pervis should have been smart enough just to get away from his man there.
What a play, Billy. The steal by LeBradford.
And they tried to hit ahead. LeBradford came all the way across the court, made the throw back inside, goes down over the benches, got back in. Great play for Louisville.
Louisville has moved in front midway first half. Louisville on a 9-3 run has moved in front of UNLV. The off-court headlines of UNLV and Coach Jerry Tarkanian came to a head in the recent Supreme Court ruling. Now it puts the Tark the Shark in a tough position.
There's something that's on my mind every day, you know, at least sometime in the day, and it does bother you, and it is difficult, but, you know, it's just something you have to deal with, and I think the kids are... We don't talk at all with the team about it, and I think that they're handling it pretty well.
Billy, you talked to Tark yesterday. There's another three-pointer is fired up by Anthony, and Anthony retrieves his own miss.
Tark says Lois, his wife, is taking it harder than he is, and she's a fighter.
After Hunt's miss, again, UNLV has the basketball. Anthony back out to Anderson Hunt. The freshman fires. And a rebound underneath by Louisville and an over-the-back foul on Moses Scurry, his first.
Holden did a super job blocking out Scurry that time. Had him perfectly wedged out, and Scurry had to go over his back.
That's team foul number five. UNLV going to man-to-man.
Oh, and back with Anthony in the game, they go to man-to-man. Felton Spencer in there now. Beautiful feed.
And a foul underneath. Again, Pervis Ellison had the ball underneath. The
against Butler, his first. Now, Ellison got Ackles in foul trouble right off the bat. A little push off, but excellent bounce pass inside by Felton Spencer. The high-low post offense executed to perfection. So in addition to what Pervis has done in terms of his stats, he's 3 for 3 for the day. He also has built up 4 fouls on the interior players for UNLV.
James Jones comes in for the Runnin Rebs, replacing Scurry. Ellison, 60% this year from the line, connects on the first. Up now. You notice two freshmen in the lineup.
You notice Louisville has not gone to their 2-2-1 press much today. Pick up full court, kind of a little dummy pressure.
Inside pass. And Jones is fouled by Felton Spencer. First chance to talk about the 7-footer. Junior out of Louisville.
Had 3 outstanding games in a row. Did not play well early in the year. I thought that was a good question you asked yesterday, Jim, of Danny Crum. How come they don't play more together between Ellison and Felton Spencer? But his answer was he just wasn't playing that well, but he's coming on strong now and gives them an added dimension.
Spencer is the only 7-footer to play ball at Louisville. They had a player back in the mid-70s, Ricky Gallen, who was 6'11", but Spencer, a 7-footer. As we see Jones make the free throw for UNLV.
And look for Pervis Ellison to touch it a little bit here, because if they could get Butler in some further trouble, they'd really be in business.
Tried to get it into Spencer. It's knocked away, and the ball belongs to the Runnin Rebs.
I think the official missed that one. Denny Crum had really a better angle on it than did the official.
Anthony will inbound. UNLV's only 2 losses to Oklahoma and Arizona. Foul is called on the Cardinals, James Brewer.
James first.
Jerry Tarkanian. Billy is the winningest active coach, and with a victory today, he actually becomes the all-time winningest coach percentage-wise. Denny Crum is 5th on the active list.
You know, when you think about Tark, he's got to go like 27-3 every year to stay up there with Claire B. Maybe he goes 26-4, he falls behind him.
For about a 3-month stretch last year, he was the all-time winningest coach with Tarkanian. B has gone back ahead. Anthony is fouled on the jumper.
Brewer is some athlete. Outstanding football player. Nice gesture here, going over and shaking hands. Anthony's got a good vertical leap as well.
Brewer is out of Bardstown, Kentucky, and he is replaced by Keith Williams.
This is one of the reasons that I think this is Denny's strongest club, because he just can go to that bench and bring in quality players. He's 10 deep, and as we said, Everett Sullivan out of the game today would be another outstanding player that he could go to.
Well, Anthony misses the first free throw. He was actually invited to the Olympic trials, was one of the early cuts. He's trying to learn how to play the point for Tarkini.
That's right. He was an outstanding, really number 2 guard. He's come in. He's a great defender. Now learning how to distribute the ball a little bit.
And he's going against LeBradford Smith right now on defense.
You see, Louisville just can't get into their normal flow of their offense. Great switch. That may be as good a half-court defense as a college team can play.
6'1", Greg Anthony, taking away from 7-footer Spencer. And the misfire picked up by the Cardinals. Here's a steal.
Uh-oh, Anthony hurt his ankle.
Louisville's coming up with another steal. Anthony coming down, I believe. Bad angle on the ankle.
And Jerry Tarkanian put his hands right on top of his head in one of those painful gestures of his. Anthony in some pain himself. Craig Hawley getting ready to come into the ballgame. Pervis takes the seat.
Billy, the lower part of your screen, I believe we'll see it here. Anthony.
Oh, he just twisted it down inside. You know, I think he's going to be all right, though. At least he didn't step on somebody's foot and really double that up.
Anderson Hunt and Clint Rossum return to the UNLV lineup. And as Billy mentioned, Craig Pauley is in for the first time for Louisville.
Now, I didn't see this play where the foul was called. Technical against the UNLV assistant, which would be a two-shot and the ball.
Kenny Payne will shoot the technical.
Now, that's really not a wise move for any assistant coach, obviously, because the referees had called the timeout.
I think Jerry just found out about it, too. His arms up.
Yep. Wanted to know where that came from. You know, talking about his situation involving the NCAA, I think that Dick Schultz has a good handle on it. So, you know, he talks about a reasonable approach to how that will be handled. I understand that UNLV is going to make some proposals and then see if they can't go along and let's move forward with it.
Louisville with the ball and a two-point lead inside of 10 minutes. Spencer is clobbered. From all angles.
And one of the things that's happening is the fact that Louisville is swinging the ball to the high post. When they do that, they're catching UNLV, who always tries to deny the ball inside. They're catching them at an angle where they then can dump back down inside low. That's about the third time they've been able to get that entry from the high down to the low post.
Foul was the first on James Jones. Spencer will shoot again.
70% free throw shooter. And this may sound ridiculous, but Jim, although he is not a starter for Louisville, I would say that he'll be a first-round draft choice when he gets out of here. There's the 2-2-1 full-court press.
Everyone looking for size.
And I don't think they'd be making a mistake drafting him either. He's got a lot of ability.
They call him, Spencer here, the Chief, like Robert Parrish.
He's an excellent student, guy that can learn the game. He works hard at it. And as you said, has the size.
Barry Young is in the game now for UNLV. The Rebels have it underneath. And Butler is called for Seth. Tim Nance along with Billy Packer from sold-out Freedom Hall in Louisville. Cardinals have taken the lead after UNLV burst out front by five early.
It's a power cut by Louisville. Again, going high-low post.
Spencer. And they're going to say he was tied up, and the possession arrow belongs to the Runnin Rebels.
And Jerry Tarkanian was kind of upset that Butler was not able to convert on the other end. But what's happening to Butler, again, as I said early on in the show, is it's the first time he's got somebody down there that can go up with him and block his shot. Because it's the second time today he walked when he apparently had an open shot.
Anderson Hunt is bringing the ball up now with Anthony on the bench with the ankle sprain.
Young is best shooter. Walks.
Barry Young, seventh turnover on UNLV. Kimbrough comes back in for the freshman Cornelius Holden. Keith Williams with the ball and Tony Kimbrough were teammates in high school. Seneca High School in Louisville. Underneath to Spencer and a foul on the man running him, James Jones. That's his second. Near the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game for each team. And in their honor, Chevrolet will donate a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. That's coming up a little bit later this afternoon. Shelton Spencer at the line, 1-1.
Good looking free throw.
Spencer played at Eastern High School in Louisville with Herbert Crook, who's a member of the championship team here at Louisville in 1986. 6-point lead for the Cardinals.
Back to the 2-2-1. Look for UNLV to throw over the top of that all the way down court. They had Augmon open.
Augmon driving. Knocked away. and a foul against Louisville. Stacy was passing that ball. And with a little better use of the right hand, he had himself a little hook across the lane. As we saw earlier in the game, Pervis Ellison was able to use that left hand and got off the shot.
Foul was on Hawley, his first.
Inside the Butler, he turns around quickly and scores. 21-17 Louisville. That's a good thing to do, Jim, against a guy that's a shot blocker. Don't use the pump fake sometimes. Just put it up quickly. Spencer, interior passing to Kimbrough for the bucket. Tony Kimbrough sat out last year because of academic difficulty. Got a lot stronger. And I think he learned a lot about the game sitting there watching.
Clint Rossum. And a rebound by Augmon. Augmon missing underneath. Ball is loose. Williams has it. Ahead to LeBradford Smith. He'll pull up, shoot the three. Spencer pulls it down.
Spencer giving him a big lift in this ball game, particularly with Ackles in foul trouble. Felton Spencer comes in, gives a good rest to Pervis Ellison, and pounds those boards.
Foul is on Stacy Augmon, his first. And Felton Spencer, you said it, Billy, earlier, he's really started to come on in the last 2 weeks for Denny Crum. Crum thought he was a little antsy in the lineup early in the season.
Well, you know, he seems to play best on national TV in intersectional games. Had the big game against Syracuse a year or so ago, and I think he just rises to the occasion.
He is 5-for-5 from the line here in the first half.
And Louisville really starting to hurt UNLV with a high-low post, getting the ball down inside. They are drawing some fouls. They might not be getting any layups, but they're getting on that foul line, and that always helps.
Spencer coming off the bench, giving his team a lift, and an 8-point lead. Bill, it's been the site of six Final Fours, the last being 1969. Louisville leading nearing the 7-minute mark here in the first half. And the game summary, Billy, 1 point. Vegas led 10-5. Louisville's come back to take an 8-point lead. Now, for an update on the injury to Greg Anthony, let's go to James Brown. James.
All right, Jimmy, thank you very much. Make no mistake about it. Greg Anthony's ankle is very sore, very tender. They're re-wrapping it. He says he's going to give it a shot. We'll see what happens. Let's go back to Jim.
All right, James, he remains out of the game at the moment. Anderson Hunt with the chore of leading this team. Bring the ball up court. Clint Rossum also can handle the ball.
Ellison and Butler really battling.
There's a steal by Williams. And a slam.
Well, Jim, I gave credit to UNLV's half-court defense. That time you have to give the accolade to Louisville. They just cut off all of Vegas' offensive pattern and created that cross-court pass with a good overplay.
Moses Scurry has come back in for Coach Jerry Tarkanian.
Butler's the man they want to get the ball to. They just can't hit him. Here he is.
Butler trying to get it over Ellison. And the rebound by Augmon. Augmon has it stripped away. 3-on-2. And Anderson Hunt with the quick hands knocking away as it was intended for Pervis Ellison.
You can see it's very difficult down in the paint to get anything off. Good outlet pass. Hawley does the right thing, hitting the ball back to the center to Williams. Williams makes the play early on. Probably should have pulled up at the foul line again. With one less dribble, he could have got that bounce pass to Pervis on the cut. UNLV goes to their amoeba defense. It's a 1-1-3. They like to put a lot of pressure on with his defense. You can see Rossum plays the second man. It's his job to go out and play on the perimeter.
Pervis. 4-for-4 from the floor is Pervis Ellison. And the largest lead of the game for Louisville, 29-17.
At this point, they're doing it with great defense.
Air ball by Hunt. Bradford Smith called for traveling.
Death ball.
Kenny Payne makes it.
Keith Williams probably could have gone long to LeBradford Smith, and particularly with this kind of a margin. You get a 12-point lead, you might want to go for the home run. And
cannot get the ball inside. 24-7 run by Louisville. Good hands by Butler. Austin had a tough start here, Billy. He's 0-3. As I said, he's not a great outside shooter, and what we're seeing is just super defense. Austin made the shot, but it's not going to count. Coming up next, we have final round coverage of the Phoenix Open. Mark Calcavecchia leading by three shots over Gary Hallberg and Mark McCumber. Look out for Chip Becky's four back. Phoenix Open final round. Pat Summerall, Kenny Venturi.
Jim, I saw two of my Wake Forest boys on that leaderboard, and I don't know. I didn't see any Houston guys up there.
Steve Elkington.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know.
He's right up there.
Did he go to Houston?
He did. Right. He's part of two national championship teams for Houston.
Well, let's see. Scott Hoke. He was part of one. Gary Holberg.
You thought you had me there.
I thought I did. I didn't know about Elkington.
Rebound after the missed free throw. Butler misses the easy shot. Kimbrough clears for Louisville.
Defense they're in right now. Curry wasn't sure. He thought they're still in the man. They're backing at a little amoeba defense.
Gary Tarkanian said yesterday he hoped he didn't have to bring out the amoeba defense.
Well, he's not getting the aggressive play out of it that he wanted, and they're a little confused right now. His problem is the fact that Louisville is playing such great defense. They have held 16 this year under 40%. The signs of some of those great Georgetown defensive clubs.
Kimbrough passed up the three. He went up for the shot. He dished it instead to Spencer. Remains Louisville's ball. Only 5 seconds on the shot clock.
They're shooting, UNLV shooting 26% from the field. They're not a real good perimeter shooting ball club, and they can't get it off inside.
But Bradford Smith, this beats the shot clock with a three, and it's a 15-point lead.
Sensational defense. Just sensational.
Pauly takes it away.
Look for Jerry Tarkini to call a timeout here. He's got to go. He's going for the time.
LeBranford Smith.
His team does not see it. He wants the timeout. Nobody sees it.
Anthony back in the game. Gotten away as he was sitting out.
You know what happens here? Every time a coach wants to do that and his team doesn't see him, they always seem to get the basket. Jerry was screaming for a timeout. It was a great run for Louisville.
It was Butler on the slam. Cool the crowd here a little bit.
You can see this defense starts out as a 1-1-3 zone. Three men across the back. Rossum and Anthony up front. Hart trying to find out some way to shut him off.
Pauly baseline. Butler in short. Butler. And a reach-in foul, a silly foul on Pervis Ellison.
That's the second one Pervis has today. Both of them were fouls that he really shouldn't have committed. One defensive end of the floor, and that one just a reach-in.
So Ellison will get a rest as Kenny Payne returns to the lineup.
Jim, Anthony going out, I thought when he came back and he looked like he was running fairly well, but they are sitting him down, the trainer working on him again. That would really hurt UNLV not to have that third guard to go to.
Butler on a 1-1 hits the front end. He has 7 points, 4 rebounds. It's David Butler, a junior out of Washington, D.C., by way of San Jacinto Junior College.
7 of 13 members of this squad are transfers into Jerry's program. That's why I think this team's going to get much better as the year goes on, because it takes a while to blend that much new talent into your team.
Billy, a timeout on the floor. With 3 minutes, 10 seconds left in the first half. 30-7 run to open up at one time a 16-point lead. It's now at 14. Billy, 1968, the Astrodome, UCLA, and Lou Alcindor at that time, going against El
Melvin Hayes in Houston. A regular season college basketball attendance mark set at the Dome that day, over 52,000. Already tickets sold for next week's game, Georgetown and LSU, 49,000 plus, a chance to set the all-time attendance figure, regular season game, that is, college basketball. Alonzo Mourning.
He's the freshman of the year in the inside so far, I guess, but Chris Jackson is the freshman of the year and maybe one of the players of the year in the outside. Two great freshmen on show.
What a game that will be. Many of you will see it next week here on CBS Sports. After missing their first six shots, the Cardinals have made 11 of their last 17.
Good defense by Butler.
Kimbrough threw it at Hawley's ankles, and it's a turnover.
Butler playing right on Kimbrough and stayed with him every step. Jerry Tarkanian said yesterday, Butler, one of the best defenders on the wings that he's ever had. And he's only in his first year there.
Barry Young loses the handle.
And the game for Louisville.
Losing control. Barry Young, sophomore out of Maryland. Williams checks back in for Denny Crump's Cardinals for Hawley.
Well, I think what you can see right now for this Vegas club is they really don't have a go-to guy on the offensive end of the court that can get them the big basket when they're in a drought.
Off balance, Smith.
Notice what he did there, Jim. He glided right back into the defender to prevent the defender from being able to get a hand up on the ball.
Hunt pulls up. Off the back of the iron. Hunt almost hits his own miss. The guy hits Smith with the personal.
Bradford down, but not out. Right back up.
He's a tough guy out of Bay City, Texas. But Bradford Smith, you know, he set the national high jump record for a freshman in high school. 6 feet, 10 inches, and I understand he had 3 days to prepare.
Well, you know, I talked to him yesterday about his baseball prowess. He's supposed to be a 90-mile-an-hour fastball pitcher, and I asked him if he threw any last year, and he said not in competition, but he did loosen up some, and he said he believes this year, if he's not worn out from basketball, oh, great steal. And he's going to try to throw a little bit maybe this spring.
Steal by Spencer.
Having some gain inside. Big lift for Denny Crump.
Kimbrough off the double team. Finds the open man.
If I'm not mistaken, Jim, Felton Spencer has won our MVP, our CBS MVP, about three times in his career, and he's on the mark today to be there again.
He has 8 points, and he's going to the line.
A little push off, but not a foul there, and then he showed that strength as he was able to take the ball up to the basket anyway.
He is 7-for-7 from the stripe, and it's 40-21, Louisville.
They have just shut UNLV off defensively.
Move by Hunt, but he gets the shot inside. Scurry follows for the bucket.
Tark says one of the reasons Scurry's such a great offensive rebounder is he misses so many shots, he gets his own rebound. That wasn't the case in that time. They're extending that defensive zone out now.
Kimbrough's the open man.
Wasn't ready, and he hit it anyway.
That was a frozen rope.
It sure was. I don't think he released it the way he wanted to, and he got the basket. Spencer made the super pass.
20-point lead as we near the minute mark here in the first half. Scurry.
Well, look at Scurry battling on that offensive board.
Billy coming up at halftime. James Brown on the road to the Final Four here on CBS, the home of the NCAA tournament. James will have a feature on St. Mary's College of California. You like that team out west, St. Mary's.
Well, I have not seen them, Jim, but I've talked to a lot of people who have played against them, and early on they said, you know, the best club in the west may be St. Mary's. Now, I'd have a hard time believing that over the likes of a Arizona or a UNLV, but obviously a real good dark horse-type club for the NCAA tournament.
Brewer comes in, replacing Smith. Scurry will have one more after making the first. St. Mary's of Moraga, California. I used to live right off that campus. Beautiful place. The Gales. They used to be a football power back in the 30s.
Lynn Nance had, the coach there, had some background here in the state of Kentucky.
David Butler pulled out awful high. They could throw over his head as they do.
Brewer. Sijanovic on him. Now Sijanovic shifting over to Williams.
What's happening now? They're starting to extend this defense so far out, there's going to be some holes right in the middle. See, they had the defense spread out. A lot of opening.
Look for Spencer to come open.
Sure do.
And taken away by Butler. Inside of 30 seconds. Sijanovic. DeYoung. Away from the ball. A foul on Felton Spencer. They knock Scurry to the floor. Second on Spencer.
You'll see everybody fighting for position here now. Felton Spencer fighting to get over the top. Scurry locks him and just catches Spencer's arm in there inadvertently. But a good call by the official.
Scurry goes back to the line. 1-1 for Scurry. His brother Terry Scurry played in the NBA for two seasons with the Utah Jazz and the New York Knicks.
He has three brothers that play college basketball. Pretty good recruiting family.
From Brooklyn, New York. Rockham with a three. Crashing the boards and a foul on Scurry.
You can see that UNLV is getting a little frustrated. I thought this may happen, one team or the other get frustrated on the other team's ability to shut them down inside.
Billy, you said that this morning. You felt that it would be some sort of encounter between these Giants.
Yeah, when you're usually, as an individual, and then in this particular case as a team, when you're usually capable of going above your opponent time after time to block each other, to go over him, and all of a sudden you face a club that can stay up there with you, something's got to give. And in this game, it has been Louisville that's gotten control inside. Kind of like a line of scrimmage in a football game. You know, great offensive line, defensive line. In this case, shot blockers against good dunkers.
One of the reasons Louisville's winning that battle was Spencer, who goes back to the line now for a 1-1.
And the game for Louisville,
Pauley will come in replacing Brewer.
Benny Crum was forced to get small. I mean, Jerry Durkini was forced to go small when Ockles got those three personal fouls right off the bat first 4 or 5 minutes of the first half.
First miss. Picked up by Payne.
Good idea.
Quick. Young. And it's up and down. With 2 seconds left, Payne put it up rather quickly.
I think that he thought that there are probably 2 seconds. Now, what Vegas has to watch is that Payne and Kimbrough are going to go out on the wings here on the out-of-bounds situation. They got to be careful for the jump shot. There's Payne.
Payne with a three.
He got it. Oh! Easier to say than do, but Louisville did.
Formerly had problems as far as three-point shooting. Not this year, 6 for 9 in the first half. Billy, what a shot by Jim.
Well,
Payne.
You knew this was coming. This is an out-of-bounds set that they used. Payne and Kimbrough were spread wide. You've got to prevent them from touching that ball there. Great shot. Tark will put that hand right on top of that head, probably. He cannot believe this first half.
The sad look gets a little sadder. And after a 10-5 lead early, Louisville goes on a 41-14 stretch the rest of the way. That's the end of the first half with the score. Louisville leading 10th-ranked UNLV by 22 at halftime. And Billy, let's tell the story here through the stats.
Well, you can see UNLV not shooting well from the outside. Louisville, that never even used to go for the three, shooting very well. Field goal shooting percentage, Louisville just doing a great job defensively there. And the turnovers and the turnover points, you can see Louisville really is doing a job once they turn over that ball, turning it right into their offense.
Ellison the top point getter, but a big lift by Spencer off the bench. Here's Ellison with the ball as we start the second half. Williams inside to Ellison. Back out to Kimbrough. That's a three, it was ruled. No good, of course. And out of bounds belonging to UNLV. Let's set the lineups on the court. For Louisville, it's Kenny Payne, Keith Williams, Tony Kimbrough, Pervis Ellison, and LeBradford Smith, the starters. And for UNLV, Anderson Hunt with the ball. in there for Greg Anthony, who has been taken for x-rays of that ankle. Butler, Ackles back in with three fouls. Ackles has it swatted away by Ellison. And Augmon scores for the first time today.
That was a great drive by Ackles. He never could have anticipated Pervis Ellison was going to come across the lane and make that play. We're back to the amoeba defense again. Hunt out front. Keith Williams will take that three-pointer from out there if he gets caught in that wedge again.
Double-teamed inside and knocked away by Ackles and picked up by Rossler.
Crum upset a little bit with Williams, who did not penetrate with the ball down inside. Too long a passing lane.
Freshman Anderson Hunt. Out to pass to Ackles. Ackles and Augmon scoring back-to-back buckets to start the second half. The two starting forwards for UNLV did not score in the first half, but they open up on the board here to begin the second stanza.
Jim, what's happening here? Vegas going ahead and penetrating with the dribble through the defense.
Rossum almost forces the steal. Ellison gets it back. Payne will fire.
What beautiful form he has on that jump shot.
3-point goal for Kenny Payne. That is his first.
Into the half with a three.
And beat Georgia Tech just last weekend with two threes down at the wire. One from the top of the key for the win. Bradford Smith caught on Augmon. They're trying to get him the ball in the dump. There it is.
Illinois is the only unbeaten team in Division I, has the longest active winning streak, then Louisville and Indiana with 12, and West Virginia last night a winner over Temple, all with 12-game winning streaks. Runnin Rebs with 11. Of course, Louisville can make
When's the last
today.
Time that you saw this happen in college basketball this late a date? Illinois probably is going to be, and I think certainly will be, number one in the nation. But you know what? They're number two in the Big Ten. Indiana, number one in the Big Ten. A surprise there. Bob Knight has them rolling. A good win streak.
Play more conference games.
That's right. Both have a...
Do you think Illinois is the best team in the country, Billy?
Do I think they're the best? I don't think there is a best team right now.
Ellison scores and is fouled.
But if you have to have a vote, Jim, you're going to go with the team that's undefeated, obviously.
You have to right now.
Sure.
For sure.
Pervis Ellison, dish on the inside, great touch pass. Ellison sets it up perfectly to go down the lane.
Perfect day so far for Pervis. Perfect Pervis, 5 for 5 from the floor, 3 for 3 from behind.
And no more nervous Pervis, huh? Perfect Pervis. I think that may be a better description. Never nervous Pervis has become perfect Pervis.
I think I'd rather be perfect than never nervous. Hunt driving baseline.
Well, that's something. That might have been offensive.
That should have been offensive.
The ball was touched before it went through the cylinder. Now, what UNLV is doing is penetrating with the dribble. They're picking up their defensive pressure, and although they're down 21, they're making a nice little run here. At least they're making a statement.
Oh,
what hands. What hands. Oh.
Reaching back and scoring.
Yeah, tremendous footwork and great hands on the inside. Against good shot blocker.
Over the head of Butler, another turnover. That's the 13th on the Runnin Rebs today.
And what's happening to UNLV is that Louisville's playing such great half-court defense, they've taken them out of their offensive sets and creating passes like that.
It away.
Jim, on that last play where Pervis Ellison threw it away, it will be his turnover, but Williams didn't create a passing lane for him. He saw that Ellison was in trouble. He needed to go to the ball and shorten up that passing lane. He just stood still.
A lot of pressure today, Billy, on Anderson Hunt, the freshman out of Detroit, who has come in for Greg Anthony. Anthony injured an ankle in the first half, has been taken for x-rays. Hunt scoring trying to complete now a three-point play. He does.
Could be a pretty good weekend in the Bluegrass State. Kentucky with that big win over Tennessee last night, putting them back in the hunt in the SEC. I never realized Tennessee had beaten Kentucky 14 out of 16 games on their home court.
Rebound by Hunt. Big crowd last night.
Yep. Anderson Hunt really has a feel for offensive rebounding. There is a dunk, that one by Stacy Augmon.
Well, the Runnin Rebels have come back, and it's 54-36. 18-point lead. Inside of 16 minutes left in the game.
Notice how Pervis comes up, beats the ball, eliminates the threat.
Steal forced by Hunt, picked up by Rossum. Hunt is tripped up, and a foul is called on Smith. The Bradford Smith. What a follow-up slam by the Olympian, Stacy Augmon.
You see Hunt takes it down the lane, pulls up. Now watch Stacy Augmon pick that one off and put it right on through. Good, clean play. Stacy is so quick. Took off and timed it perfectly.
The third foul on the Bradford Smith. Early action in the second half.
Okay, here's we're going to see this amoeba defense. Stacy Augmon way out here in the double team. The ball will be thrown down inside. Now watch this defense. Man moves out inside. A man comes over the top, and then the John Egley, the old Penn State switch in the zone. Watch how Augmon ends all the way across court. This great defensive play right here. Augmon goes all the way across the court. Vegas adjusts. Great defensive play, and that's what the amoeba is about in one aspect.
Vegas has come out, UNLV, and hit five of six shots here to begin the second half. 22-point lead at halftime by the Cardinals. Now at 18, Butler inside, and rebounded by Payne.
Nice job by Felton Spencer.
Behind the back, James Brewer, freshman for Louisville. Throws it away, intended for the Bradford Smith. Felton Spencer in for the first time here in the second half for Louisville as well. And Illinois will move up to number one this week.
Again, that's the second time this year they've come back from a big first half deficit. Did it against Missouri as well. Mark of a good club.
Traveling on James Brewer.
Nice piece of officiating there. You don't have the block charge. Brewer wasn't sure the man was there, and he took an extra step. Now, if he has the ball, the defender doesn't have to give him any step at all. If he has not yet caught the ball, the defender has to give him a full stride.
Hunt Rossum over to Augmon. Augmon driving over Payne. Comes down to Spencer.
Jim, I think Denny Crum was listening to you when you said, how come those two big guys don't play together? They're doing a job of it here today.
And there's one of them. Ellison scoring and getting fouled.
What that double post really creates a problem for is tough to match up with him. Ellison has a good hand. Good hit on the inside by Payne. And the reason he's so wide open there is Felton Spencer's taking a man out of the post area. And in that particular case, it was Butler.
Well, Philly has been well documented. Pervis Ellison, the MVP of the Final Four as a freshman. First freshman since Arne Farron, 1944. University of Utah. Since that time, Ellison, the last 2 years, some have been down a little bit on Pervis, but Denny Crum talked about it yesterday to us, that he really didn't have the supporting cast,
particularly with the with the outside perimeter shooting. Great steal by Williams.
Williams scores right off the steal from Anderson Hunt.
Vegas really missing Greg Anthony now.
And another steal.
And Hunt's inexperience against this type of pressure is really showing up.
Smith. Spencer underneath.
Frustrating day for the Runnin Rebs. Going man to man. Felton Spencer giving Ackles all he can handle inside.
Over Rawson. Rebound by Augmon. Comes the Runnin Rebs. Augmon is fouled on the jump shot. Fouled by Kenny Payne. That's his second. Team foul number four.
You know, Stacy does a great job in the open court area with the dribble.
Billy, you talked to Stacy yesterday. I got the impression he'd like to shed that defensive specialist image he has.
Yeah, I think that, and with the exception of being an outstanding perimeter shooter, I think in my mind he has already taken away that image that he's just a defensive specialist. He handles the ball well. He's a good passer, excellent rebounder on both ends of the court. There he has a special haircut shaved in, number 32.
Number 34, James Jones, replacing number zero, David Butler.
I don't think that's part of the uniform there to have your numbers shaved into your head, but Stacy must like it.
One of the tonsorial skills of Brian Bosworth displayed by Stacy Augmon.
Still playing that tough man-to-man. I'm surprised you're not going in there to get Ackles out of the ballgame.
Oh, what a rejection by Ackles. Picked up by Hunt. Over to Rossum for a three. 59-41. Louisville. Foul called on Stacy Augmon. Third on Augmon.
Now, what's happening to Bradford Smith? He's got to realize that Felton Spencer has got Ackles pretty well handled down inside, particularly when Pervis is up at the high post, and he ought to start feeding down inside instead of taking so much one-on-one.
How about that time Ellison just reached over the defenders and took the ball away? Coming up next, final round coverage of the Phoenix Open, the TPC course out in Scottsdale, Arizona. Mark Calcavecchia leading by five shots as he goes to the eighth hole. 17 under for the tournament through seven today. Scott Hope currently in second. Phoenix Open coming up next.
There's the man.
Spencer. And a slap by Rossum.
That high-low post is just causing all kinds of problems.
A foul is on Rossum, number 22.
Spencer has been visiting the free throw line a number of times today. He's already had eight attempts, 7 for 8 from the line, 9 points and 4 rebounds for Felton Spencer.
And when you look at his stroke there today, you can see why he's shooting so well today, and you wonder, although he's a 70% free throw shooter, he's even potentially better. 12 of 14 from the line is the team, mostly because Felton Spencer has only missed one. What's that, 9 out of 10?
9 out of 10, good form for Spencer. 11 points now, and a timeout. Timeout by UNLV. It's a 20-point lead for the rest of the game at Freedom Hall in Louisville. And Louisville leading by 20. At one point early in the game, UNLV led 10-5, and then with a one-point lead at 16-15, the starting point guard Greg Anthony went out with an ankle injury. Since that time, it's been all Louisville. 16-15 when Anthony left. 31-8 run the rest of the way in the first half, and a steal by Pervis Ellison.
Well, Louisville goes back into the zone. Pervis was just hiding back in behind there as one of the back men. Judged it perfectly, that cross-court pass.
No, he's nearly perfect.
Yes, he is. And here we have both clubs playing his own, which is very uncharacteristic of
him.
Ellison, turn around. That's his first miss. First miss of the day for Ellison. Augmon running back out of there to Hunt. He'll take the three. Anderson Hunt, what do you think of his play in the relief role today?
Well, I think that he's going to be an outstanding guard for UNLV, but one of the things today really has probably impressed him is that he's got to understand what the defense is giving him. He's got a lot of good natural instincts, got a lot of moxie, good skills, but he just needs experience.
Here's Steele by Augmon. Felton Spencer snaps it over to LeBradford Smith. And here is a steal by Butler. Actually going to call it jump ball. The possession arrow belongs to UNLV.
Brad Stanford Smith having a hard time deciding whether he wants to take the shot or dump off. Well, the other thing that impressed me about Felton Spencer is what good condition he's in. He had a little bit chunky when he was a high school player. Now he's just getting raw out there. Strong run.
Rebound, offensive board by Augmon. And two shots just dribble right off the rim. Augmon again, and by a foul. Philly, Augmon, if he can convert on the free throw, can knock the lead down to 14.
DJ Carlos Moore's club continues to roll out of conference.
The third foul on Spencer, and Kimbrough will come in replacing Kenny Payne. Augmon has really improved here in the second half after a scoreless first half. Augmon now with 9 points, eight rebounds.
Well, as
one free throw here, Billy.
As you know, they're a member of the Big West, a change of name this year, the BCAA, and now the Big West. Jerry Tarkanian, considering that being the same league, has got 10 years in and 10 regular season championships. The club obviously favored again this year.
Already 7-0 in the Big West, and another turnover by Louisville. It's 61-47. And the Runnin Rebels
got a three.
Rossi will take the three. And it's an 11-point game.
Denny Crum has seen enough. He's going for his own timeout.
61-50. After a 23-point lead at one time by Louisville, it's down to 11. CBS Sports coverage, 61-50. Freedom Hall in Louisville, over 19,000. Sold out today to see their Cardinals leading over number 10, UNLV. Louisville shooting 7 for 11 from three-point range. Louisville has converted the turnovers of the Runnin Rebels into 24 points. Ellison, the top scorer, Spencer off the bench with 11 points. Louisville, however, has missed its last five shots, and the Runnin Rebels work their way back into it, Billy.
Well, look for Pervis Ellison to touch the ball this time down the floor. I think that the judgment by Louisville in their half-court offense has really been something to be left to be desired here in regard to what Bradford Smith is doing distributing the ball. Vegas going back to their amoeba defense again.
15 on the shot clock. And off the double team, Ellison is fouled. Kurt Rawson is called on the foul, his third.
Purvis saying that he was in the act of shooting but was not.
Billy, next Saturday, you and Brett Busberger, two of you back again, bringing all of us a colossal matchup between Georgetown and LSU, the outstanding freshman, Lonzo Mourning, Jackson for LSU. Fifth hits the three for Louisville. Stops the streak temporarily for UNLV. Up next week, we'll be seeing Wichita State against BYU. College basketball action next Saturday here on CBS.
Fans really getting into it, wanting that defensive pressure back. He takes the offense.
He answers right back with a three of his own. 64-53.
Vegas showing a lot of heart here as a ball club.
Spencer misses the dunk. What a play by Butler.
Spencer was wide open. He tried to do it with gusto and it put it right back up.
Ellison out high on Hunt. Inside Augmon. Use the glass.
That ball was tipped by Felton Spencer.
Goaltending. It is. He made right on the rim, Billy.
It may have been outside the cylinder, but Felton Spencer got a piece of it.
Augmon now with 15 points.
See if this ball isn't outside the cylinder. Well,
looks like it's on the rim.
Yeah, it was still hanging up there. Great defense again by UNLV.
And it's another turnover. Louisville throws it away on the inbound pass. And Crum brings in Kenny Payne for Felton Spencer.
Denny Crum goes smaller. And what's happening here with Butler and Ackles, who is now on the bench, and Augmon, they're just getting up on the board.
This inside, of 10 minutes. UNLV has come right back to get into this game.
Tough shot, not a good shot, but Rossum follows
and scores. It's a 21-5 run for the Runnin Rebels, and the lead is at 7.
Well, sometimes you go into that locker room at halftime and you just think you've got a game put away.
Foul is called.
Jones better be careful. They've already in the first half had a technical on the, from the bench, which was a two-shot technical. They don't need another one.
That's number 4 on Jones. And a 1-1 situation coming up for Tony Kimbrough.
Knuckles is coming back in the ballgame for Jones. I think all that Jerry Tarkanian wanted there is to get a couple of minutes. Knuckles had not picked up any fouls here in the second half after picking up 3 that really hurt UNLV in the first half early on.
Bogdanovich comes in for Rossum.
This kind of hurts Jerry Tarkanian having Anthony out with the injury because his normal 3-guard rotation just not there today.
1-1 for Kimbrough.
One of the most heralded high school prospects to come out of the state of Kentucky in quite some time. Struggled a little bit early in his career. Went to the Final Four, as everybody knows, on that national championship team. Only solid ball now.
He was the first sub on that championship team of 86.
Pervis fighting over the top.
Tackles in the lane. Foul on Payne.
You see Pervis Ellison, how hard he's working on defense. That wasn't his man. He came all the way across the lane trying to make the block.
Eccles played in high school basketball in North Carolina.
Down in Manio, North Carolina. Manio to Murphy. It takes you all the way across the state. I asked him yesterday if he'd ever been to Murphy. He said he heard of it, but he's never been over there. He's a man from the coast, the Outer Banks.
Cape Hatteras area of North Carolina. Tackles. He's only been playing basketball for 5 years. Was a soccer goalie. I know another basketball player that could say that.
I was just going to say, Team Elijah won the goalie. Oh, hand check that time by Butler. Got away with it.
Brewer palmed it.
Yep. Well, Jerry Tarkanian said Butler's as good at defending as for a big man out in the open court, and that time he took on a guard.
Center taking on a guard, and Brewer turned it over. So UNLV could cut into this lead even a little more.
Oh, good penetration.
Kimbrough. Kimbrough and Payne. Both came down with it. That's a violation.
I thought it'd be a held ball situation, but they called Payne for the walk. Now here, if you're Vegas, you want to be very patient. You got a full 45 on the clock. Try to be patient to get an absolutely good shot because they've worked hard to get it down into this position where they can go to 5.
Hunt goes out and Rossum comes in.
Well, Tark just trying to keep somebody fresh to go down the wire here. Bogdanovich has got to give him about 4 or 5 key minutes.
Austin driving, putting it up.
Beautiful play.
The lead is now at 5, 66-61. 8:21 left in the game.
Just show you a little bit about this ball club in regard to their heart, the way they're taught to play the game.
Tremendous heart displayed by UNLV, and Ackles almost makes a steal.
I think the key thing here is how well both of these clubs are taught fundamentally. In the case of Vegas, their defense is going to be consistent every game. They're not a real good shooting club, but they've been doing it by just being so solid defensively. And Louisville has not been able to turn them over as they did in the first half.
Ellison over Ackles. Ellison now with 20 points.
Well, he gets quiet 20, doesn't he?
His foot.
Well, Tark trying to get a couple of minutes out of Bogdanovich. He knows that he'd be better off out there with Hunt in the game, but he wants him to be fresh.
UNLV bench
on their feet. And their team has come back from a 23-point deficit, getting at one time within five. The lead is now at seven for Louisville.
Playing that full court zone press, and they're staying right in it. Ackles picks up a short ball, trying to fight for position against Pervis Ellison.
Billy, we have the foul down low.
They've been calling this tight all day. I'll be honest with you, I think it's pretty good defense. He's fighting to try to get position, and he's fighting against a guy that knows how to get great low post offensive position. So Ackles picks up his fourth and is going to have to sit down. Tark may look to bring him back in a hurry, though, because he's within striking distance here. And it isn't going to be the kind of situation you'll need him in the last 2 or 3 minutes of the game if you don't make a strike now.
Pervis hits on the front end of the 1-1. He's 5-for-5 from the line.
You know, that stat where he is the only man in the country last year to have over 100 blocks, points, rebounds, and assists is kind of interesting to show what a total all-around player he is.
Back in the game. UNLV breaks the press.
Pervis coming out to help and trap.
With a three. And over the back is Butler of UNLV.
And you can see there again, missing Greg Anthony. There were 26 seconds left on the shot clock. No reason to force up a bad shot.
Louisville shooting 17 of 19 from the line. Tony Kimbrough facing a 1-1. Throw with 7 points.
Well, Louisville really with almost six guys that are averaging over 10 a game. Highest score, Pervis, was 16 a game, so it's a typical Denny Crum team. You know, no 20-point-per-game scores, but everybody capable of getting themselves 12, 14 points.
You would think a guy like Pervis Ellison one time would explode for a 35-point game or something during his career. I think his high is 28.
Right, he's never had a 30-point game in his entire career. Second highest game he ever had was the finals of his freshman year in the championship.
25, Augmon. And Ellison on the outlet pass to Williams, led him too much. Turning it back over to UNLV.
And Keith Williams really didn't give Pervis much of an angle to throw that pass. Pervis kind of hung up a little bit.
James Jones will inbound at midcourt. Gary Young coming in for Nevada Las Vegas for Stacy Augmon.
You can see the confidence Gary Young has. He's taking Augmon out. He's figuring he's got maybe a 2-minute rest and on the way back. Now, where Vegas did well is to penetrate with the dribble against this defense. Let's see if they go back to it.
To Butler.
Oh,
nice soft touch by Butler.
Well, this club only has one senior on it. Gets Larry Johnson coming to join them next year, so it is going to be a tough team, not only this season, but for the future.
Larry Johnson, the hot prospect out of Odessa Junior College. Made it pretty far this year in the Olympic trials. Hunt with a long three.
They're very impatient here. Shot selection hurting him.
Inside of 6 minutes, 71-63, Cardinals. Kimbrough, he was fouled.
It's a great touch pass by the Bradford Smith.
Let's get a report on Greg Anthony, James Brown.
All right, Jim, as you and Billy called it at the end of the first half, Anthony tested his ankle but found out that it was too tender on the bone on the outside of his ankle as well as the tendon. He's gone for precautionary x-rays, and the impact of his absence, it's been obvious. Let's go back to Jim.
Kimbrough missing the first. I think it took the Rebels a while to recover. Anthony going out of the game, but
now
And the problem they've got now is he's out of the coaching box. Tark has got to be right for a correctable error. Yep. You have an assistant and Tark out of the coaching box. Now you can go up there for a correctable error, which could be the wrong man on the line. But obviously the officials didn't agree and Tark got stuck.
So now the two-shot technical and the ball will belong to the Cardinals. That's a critical time.
It sure is, because in the first half, Jimmy, remember there was also a two-shot technical on the bench.
And LeBron shooting the technicals. He's made 23 of his last 24 attempts of the free throw line. We'll have one more.
He borders on a 90% free throw shooter all the time. Excellent man to have on that line, particularly at the end of the ball game, handling the ball.
Tarkanian, I believe, is upset because the foul was called on Rossum, which was his fourth. He felt it should have been called on Barry Young.
Well, you don't want to make that type of a plea, though, to pick up that a two-shot technical over a decision like that.
Payne for the three.
Well, you talk about a five-point play.
Suddenly it's 14. Moses Scurry underneath, wildly putting it up. Out of bounds belonging to UNLV.
You know, all Moses likes to do is just get it up on the backboard so he can go get it again. He just throws it up there and gets ready to bounce.
Somewhere in the vicinity.
Yep.
In the game for the
like grenades or
George Eccles, number 44. And he replaces number 35, Moses.
Eccles has been in foul trouble all day, picking up three early ones. Rossum with four. As well, Rossum with the ball remaining in the game. Some sort of open shot.
Well, one of the things, if you're a Denny Crum, that you'd have to be aware of in this game is that when UNLV decided to penetrate with the dribble, they kind of broke down the defense a little bit.
Kenny Payne just picked up his fourth.
Well, even with Everett Sullivan out with an injury, this Louisville team is so deep that you can't ever see them getting into serious foul trouble.
So Felton Spencer returns for Payne and Augmon for Danny Young, the UNLV substitution. 5 minutes, 12 seconds left in the contest. 77-63 Louisville.
And you know, Vegas next week at this time will be taking on Oklahoma, so it's not like they're not going to have some serious competition outside the conference. We also have them later on this year against LSU, so taking on a tough schedule.
David Butler gets the offensive rebound on the missed free throw. Austin puts it inside to Butler, and he's fouled. Score the bucket.
Excellent two-man game.
Butler.
He had Felton Spencer right on his shoulders and was able to hold him off.
Fourth on Spencer. Butler doing quite a job in there. He picked up the rebound off the missed free throw from Hunt. Now scores inside. Going to reduce the lead to 10.
Well, Denny Crum has Holden to go to as well. That could be a four-pointer. Good block out.
Eccles. Momentarily out of bounds. Louisville basketball.
Just great action inside. Hard-nosed players.
Picking up three quarters court.
Yeah, that's tough. Kenny Payne walking down the sidelines. It could easily be mistaken by one of his teammates as a guy in the game, and you pass it to him.
And that'll be.
That's Eccles' fifth.
That'll be it for him.
He made a great defensive move, except he was using his right arm to hang on to Felton Spencer.
Eccles fouls out. 4 points. In the second half.
That's what, the seventh time this year that he's fouled out of a ball game, and it's certainly something he's going to have to work on.
The game for Navarro Vegas, number 34.
He's a plays by James Jones. Jones comes into the game with four personals himself.
Kind of a tough thing to do as a coach to tell him to be aggressive and then also understand when he doesn't have to be quite so aggressive. And he just battles in the low post on each and every pass, and that's where he's picking up these cheap fouls.
1-1 for Spencer. Spencer has made one field goal today.
And has what, 12 points?
12 points. He's canned 10 free throws.
Out of 11. Out of 12.
Now comes to Augmon.
Vegas made a nice run at him. I don't think they have enough left now to be able to pull this game out, but they really showed something. After being held at 28% shooting in the first half by straight defense.
Final round of the Phoenix Open coming up next.
Well, you know, Jim, we haven't seen much of Barry Young today, and needing some outside shooting, I thought maybe he'd get a call. And, of course, particularly without Anthony in the game.
Bradford Smith reached in on Butler, and that's the fourth on LeBradford Smith. Young is regarded as an excellent outside shooter. Barry Young.
That's why I said that I thought that we'd see him get the call a little bit, because they certainly needed somebody to stroke a few to force that defense to open up a little bit.
1-1 for Butler.
Butler, an impressive player out of Washington, D.C. Very quick, very agile.
4 minutes and 9 seconds left.
Senior year in high school, then, as everybody knows, went on and had a great career at San Jacinto.
10-point lead nearing the 4 minute mark of the game.
There's that 2-2-1 full court press.
Williams double teams over Payne. Payne is open. Hunt got a piece of the hand. Payne went up with the jumper.
Now, Pervis Ellison went over and did a smart thing with Kenny Payne. Kenny Payne stayed 15 feet from the basket on that play. Had he moved to the basket, he would have had himself a layup instead of getting fouled. And Pervis went over and told him, come to the pass a little bit. He'd had a layup.
Two-shot situation for Payne. Donning that number 21 that was once worn at Louisville by Scooter McRae, who this year joins any Crump coaching staff.
Well, obviously a coaching staff that's been with Denny a long time.
It's a 12-point lead inside of 4 minutes. Fans will look forward to the final round, watching Markel Kovecchia, the runner-up last year at the Masters.
You know, Jim, I was mentioning that staff, but Jerry Jones has been with Denny Crump for 17 years, and Wade Houston, who is associate head coach, been with him 13, will have his son Alan coming here next year, who's one of the top prep players in America. Stacy better be careful.
He finds Butler underneath.
No ball.
And the foul was on Pervis Ellison, his fourth.
Augmon was lucky just to get that pass off, much less to have it almost turn into a super assist.
Butler, and he will have
Butler with 14 points on the afternoon, 4 for 5 from the free throw line,
and a solid defensive effort as well.
Again, UNLV coming in today with an 11-game winning streak, while Louisville has managed 12 consecutive victories.
Well, and that only undefeated team in the country, Illinois, still has to go on the road for a lot of tough games. At Michigan, at Indiana, at Iowa.
The team on Kimbrough. Baseline is Ellison. He was fouled on the shot.
David Butler came across the top.
We've understand that Greg Anthony has returned to the bench. There he is. The crutches. The x-rays, Billy?
They're negative so far, which is good news for Greg and also for the UNLV fans. Outstanding young player.
Outstanding young man who has his real estate license already. He'd like to run for political office one day, Greg Anthony. Meanwhile, Pervis Ellison is 8-for-8 from the free throw line, 24 points for Pervis Ellison, close to his career mark.
He's running for office, the office of the nation's best player.
Where do you think he ranks, Billy, with Stacey King and Sean Elliott?
Well, Danny Ferry, there are a number of them this year making a solid run at that.
Pervis pulls down another board. Said that Ellison will be the first player selected in the NBA draft.
That was my buddy Al, who's here today, as a matter of fact. First game he's seen in 8 years that he wasn't broadcasting. So
he's checking up on it.
Yeah, that's right.
Of course, your buddy Al being Al McGuire, Kimbrough scoring for Louisville.
But, you know, I don't think he was actually reaching by saying that Pervis would be the first guy drafted, or because I think he certainly is going to be given great consideration for that.
And Butler lays it in.
And if he isn't, nobody remember what he said anyway.
Marty Blake, NBA scout, also says that Ellison will be the first player. It's a long way off, though. Five players for the Cardinals today in double figures. They lead by 13. We're inside of 2 minutes.
And that's so typical of a Denny Crum coach ball club.
Look at that pass by Ellison to Kimbrough.
He's blocked shots. He's made great passes. Tremendous defensive moves. Great pivot play. Shoots from the outside. Just a total all-around player.
And there's a timeout. 86-71, fourth-ranked Louisville, rolling to its 13th straight win. Louisville leading over UNLV in the final 2 minutes. Pervis Ellison leading the way for Louisville. 24 points for Ellison. He's our Chevrolet MVP. Stacy Augmon for the Runnin Rebels. There's a three by Anderson Hunt. 15 for the freshman Hunt.
And he going to the zone defense to end this game. Great cross-court pass.
And a little pressing.
Well, that's the way to attack that press.
Now the second highest point total of Ellison's career. 26. Hunt on another three. Knocked out of bounds.
Stacy Augmon has such good timing on his rebounding.
Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes, followed by Murder, She Wrote. Followed by the CBS Sunday movie, The Lady and the Highwayman. Now the misfire, Kimbrough underneath.
Well, you've got to go with the threes when you're down this far. Obviously, the percentage shrinks when you take them and you're not in really good rhythm.
Now an update from the TPC course in Scottsdale, the Phoenix Open final round. Chip Beck and Scott Hope, six shots back of Mark Calcavecchia. Calcavecchia can really put it together. What an explosive stretch he had yesterday.
Well, he almost did it at the Masters last year.
Kimbrough hits the free throw.
Jimmy, ought to give a little salute to C.M. Newton. Won his 500th game last night, considered by everyone one of the classiest guys in the collegiate basketball business.
Sam Newton at Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt, one of two teams this year, Xavier being the other, to beat Louisville.
Barry Goheen did it, but it's his fifth time he's been able to bury somebody with one of those wild threes of his.
Goheen made a 45-foot shot at the buzzer to beat the Cardinals early in the season, second game of the season for Louisville. Butler turning around, picked up by
Curry. You know, he is appropriately named. The way he plays, it's just one constant scurry inside.
And the two freshmen that suited up today for Louisville not to come in. Holden and Brewer. Again, we did not have a chance today to see Everett Sullivan, the brilliant freshman out of Simpsonville, South Carolina, out with a shoulder injury. Kenny Payne has fouled out. He hit that three-point shot, dramatic shot, right before the half. It made it actually a 22-point lead at the time, but had a defender draped all over him. Spencer with a big day as well for the Cardinals.
You know, considering the comeback that UNLV made in the second half, that three at the end of the first half was kind of critical. It didn't seem it at the time, but certainly proved to be later because they could have whittled that thing down to, what, 3 points.
Got as close as five in the second half to the Runnin Rebs.
Well, without the three, they could have added the two.
Brewer. Partially blocked. Picked up. He's got his career high of 28. Curry driving baseline and drawing the foul on Spencer. Now here at Louisville, they're trying to go for another Final Four here in 1994, Billy. What do you hear about that?
Well, it's a great city for a Final Four. They have tremendous accommodations. Obviously, this is a fine gymnasium if they decide to go away from a dome in a given year. Excellent airport. Nice weather. So, and a tremendous tradition for basketball. Obviously, we don't have any trouble selling any tickets here. There have been some great Final Fours played here. Matter of fact, Denny Crum said it's the first one that first time he ever came to this part of Kentucky when he came with a UCLA club that won a national championship.
Curry misses on the 1-1. And Braley in the game puts up a three. Rebounded by Rossum. Not in time. Will return. Denny Crum and the Cardinals continue on. 13 straight wins for the fourth-ranked team of the